Yeah, Seth Rail, that's, I try to put the event stuff in sooner than I did today. I've been really busy the last few days. Alright, let's go ahead and get ourselves into the trial, and then we will review all of our evidence. Especially since it's been a couple of days.
Damn right!
Looks like everyone's here.
Huh?
Is this it? Shouldn't there be more people?
Damn it!
Stop it, you're making me depressed.
Stupid fool!
How much spacing? The spacing I think I can tweak actually with the CSS margin stuff, but I don't think I'm going to try and tinker with that in the middle of a stream. So it's going to happen again. We already lost our medic. Oh, killed her. That was a fun one. Cool conflict where we must add our friends. Once we're through this, we can go back, right?
That's right!
The Monokuma bastard said so, didn't he? He said this is the last class trial.
Damn it.
We've been tricked every step of the way. There's no way I can believe that so easily.
Of course not!
I can't even believe it. The guy who's making us do all this is the one saying it, you know?
You know, right?
That's why I'll definitely survive. If we can really go home after we deal with this class trial.
That's right!
I'll definitely find out who the killer is no matter what, even if I have to pull out all the stops. What the fuck? Why are you here? You haven't realized it yet? That feeling of wanting to leave this island. Thinking like that is Monokuma's trap, you know?
Huh?
What are you saying?
Got it?
There's no way Monokuma will end things here. He's planning something far worse. Stop trying to jinx us.
Poor
Shark Week. Damn right, stupid rabbit should just shut up. Everyone, you mustn't run away from despair. Huh? I finally realized after losing my powers. I've realized that cursing your powerlessness or your fate accomplishes nothing. The possibility may be small, but as long as there's a possibility, you must face it. In order to become someone you can be proud of, or someone who can be proud of yourself. So I will fight.
Huh?
What's her deal? I do not really know, but she seems different from before. Maybe she read a self-help book.
Wait!
But her eyes, she looks so determined.
You...
What can you tell just by looking at those button eyes? Anyway, make sure you turn off Minimar. It'd be annoying if you started talking during the trial. Fine.
But still...
Somehow I understand what Monomi is saying, I think. Yeah, I'll bet you do. Anyway, let's get going to the last class trial.
Yep.
You're right, we need to fight as much as we can. No matter what hopeless truth awaits us in the end. Have they not figured out that Monomi is not working with Monokuma? Well, to be fair, Monomi trapped them on the island in the first place, right? And she's just as evasive when it comes to questions as Monokuma is, so she's not exactly the most trustworthy person either. I kept saying those words to myself over and over within my mind. I entered Monokuma Rock. Stairway to heaven, elevator to hell.
Yeah.
This elevator ride. This will be the last time for this too, right? I hope so.
Well?
Let's worry about things after we finish.
You are right.
More importantly, we must focus on the class trial before us. Yeah, she makes the point of... Yes, this
Damn
is Nagito's trial. That's why there's only the six of us left. The killer managed to kill someone like Nagito. There's no way this is going to go smoothly. I mean, I still can't believe one of us was able to do that. Nagito was problematic in many ways, but he was also a valuable asset during the trials. Yeah, you're right. In fact, during the Funhouse ordeal, we were completely dependent on him. But even if he's gone, the ones who survive need to stand and fight. We must fight. Yep, different chat setup today, Emmy. Let's see how it goes and what I need to tweak. And then the door slowly opened. This bright light greeting us. Is that the light of hope? Or the light of despair. I haven't actually talked about the death of Nagito yet, Dalai Lama. Just the overall theory I have.
Shut the hell up!
Man, I'm just fucking start this already.
Hey!
And this is it, right? This is really the last class trial, right?
Yep.
It sure is. So, I'm gonna show some enthusiasm and make sure you give it your all.
Alright!
Didn't I tell you? He said it. This is the end.
Now then!
Let's get this trial started.
Viva Killing!
This is the last class trial. Let's show some enthusiasm and kill each other.
This is the fifth class trial. According to Monokuma, this is also the last class trial. The curtain is about to rise. Nagato Komeda, the ultimate lucky student. When I first met him, I thought he was a nice guy. He came across as very sociable. But his true nature held such a demented thought process that was nothing like his outward appearance. He said he believed in hope more than anything else. He said he was yearning for a powerful hope that can overcome any despair. He said he would even help despair just to prove that hope will never lose to despair. And he said he'd be becoming a stepping stone for hope. His way of thinking was completely screwed up. But there were also times he saved us too. Yeah. Viva Killing indeed, right? Someone like him was killed. That was the end of him. I have no idea at all who did it, but there's no way we can end this without knowing. We will be consumed by despair. Damn, almost a full red page here. That's why we absolutely have to find out. The person who finished off Nagito. The killer who murdered Nagito. In order to return from this despair alive, we need to reach the truth. And the Monokuma says this is really the last class trial. That's all the more reason we need to do this. And so, this life-threatening trial billowing with hope and despair, the last one, has begun. Okay, let's double check on skills first. Alright, let's see what we can pick up. I don't think there's anything. Doesn't look like there's anything new. Nah, what the hell. I'll go ahead and take that. Yep, I saw the teaser. It looked amusing. Alright, so let's go ahead and review the information that we have on hand. So, Nagito dead inside the warehouse near the Monokuma plushie factory. I told you guys, never, never trust plushie. Estimated time of death is noon sharp, which is about the time that we entered the building. Because the bomb technically, well, technically went off early. Infinity Unlimited Flame makes your silencer stronger, which we don't use. Alright, so he's been stabbed through the stomach with a spear, multiple stab wounds on each of his thighs. Laceration on his left arm, knife impaled through his right hand. Yeah, not really going anywhere. Both of his legs were tied with rope, each rope tied to nearby pillars preventing him from moving. Thighs were also covered with a lot of stab wounds. Alright, rope that was tied to Nagito's right arm burned off, however his right sleeve still looked clean. Which means it probably wasn't necessarily the fire that burned the rope, as much as it was the lighter. Smaller concentrated flame could have been put under the rope depending on how everything was laid out. Oh, thank you for the host counts, much appreciated. I like the new chat, Kika. Let's see. Survival knife stabbed into Naito's right hand. Knife is from the military base. Safe to assume the wounds on his legs and left arm were also caused by the same knife. Hey, Tom, how's it going? Alright, blood spattered on the palm of his left hand. Okay, spatter cuts off in the middle of the palm, though, and back of his left hand has an unnatural blood stain that's only above middle joints of his fingers. Yeah, so kind of implies that he was holding something. Mouth was covered in duct tape. No blood under the duct tape, only on top of it, so clearly when he got spattered with blood, his mouth was already duct taped shut. Spear impaled him through the stomach. Cord with iron weight at the back of it extends from the back of the handle. For some reason, only the section where the cord and weight touch is bloody. Which kind of makes me wonder about this. If that's actually the blood that rubbed off, or if that's the part he was, or if that part happened to be what he was holding, which is why it's not covered in blood. Life-size Monokuma plushie found on the floor near the fire's origin point. Huge bloody hole in its stomach as if it was stabbed. Well, it's... I gotta tell you, I'm actually not entirely sure on this one. Hey, don't pick Japan! Long time no see! Watch out for Mubot, though. Wow, okay, that picked my entire coaster up, apparently. Okay, blood on the girder tells me that something was either dangling and brushing against that, or tied around it. Probably brushing against it. If it is the blood from the wire at that point. Monokuma panels tipped over. Yeah, so basically the front door was used to domino those. The question is what they actually pushed at the other end. I have some ideas. I'm wondering if it was to push the... Basically, it seems like this was the trigger point for the fire. I'm wondering, was it to push the curtain into the flame, or was it to start something up? We didn't find anything that specifically looked attached to any of this. Sure that... Okay. Japan. Just didn't unban in case Mubot actually completely destroyed you. Yeah, Mubot is absolutely out for blood where caps are concerned. How have you been? Alright, oil lighter found at the point's origin. Looks like this is what caused the fire. Since we know that can be turned on and left. MP3 player that comes to speakers. This is what was playing the music when we came in, which I believe was probably to block the sound of what was happening in the other room, because I'm pretty sure the moment we walked in, technically Nagito was alive, at least for a moment. Sonya's account, she secretly used one of the bombs from the military base of the ancient ruins, found out the bombs were fake. At the time, Monomi was apparently peeking at the whole thing, which means if we're correct about who the traitor is, then Chiaki would have also known that the bombs were fake. Monokuma knew all along the bombs were fakes, however he never told anyone. So if anyone knows that they're fake other than, well, basically, Monomi, we know where they got the info from. Oh, not bad, Japan, not bad. Been busy trying to keep the stream and everything afloat and still running. I think I'm probably going to have to pick up some contract work, though. It's probably time to find a job again. Alright, so the diary of the Monomi updated every day, except according to Monokuma, Monomi can't write, so someone else was updating it for her. And this is where things get weird. The gas mask and gloves that we found in Nagito's cottage, along with the round, thin piece of aluminum paper, which is typically what you find on tops of certain bottle types, And the poison we found in the refrigerator at Nagito's cottage, which is missing some of it. Specifically, it says that very dangerous from vaporized. Gaseous state is heavier than air, breaks down in minutes, and is susceptible to hydrolysis. You know? There's something missing from Monokuma File 5, by the way, that's actually been in all the other ones, I think. Well, it wasn't in the previous one because it wouldn't have been relevant, but normally it states there was no sign of toxins in the system. Doesn't say that this time. With him tied down there, I'm kind of wondering if the poison was actually used on him. Since it's heavier than air, it would have dropped to floor level. Working's overrated. Get you a sugar mom and take care of you while you stream all day. Yeah, easier said than done, right? And I do remember that Sephiroth. Also, I recall that she was the first person to pull out her her e-handbook and attempt to swipe it, because even if it had gone off, I suspect she knew it wouldn't have gone off. Any reason you would choose to get a Vita over the PSTV other than portability? The only other thing, honestly, is the, not everything is PSTV compatible. But the compatibility list has been far better than I expected. Alright, and last we have the Hope's Peak Academy file, which has info on all 16 people. However, Monokuma 4 is the traitor's profile, so we have no idea who the traitor is. Of course, that would mean the Monokuma knows who the traitor is. So that's all the information we have right now. As far as who did it, I gotta be perfectly honest. I kind of want to write out Akane because the whole thing just seems way too intelligent for her. I'd actually be very disappointed if it was her because I just don't think she's ever demonstrated the intelligence necessary to arrange something like this. I think the people who are here who are smart enough to do it are Shark Week, Fury Hiko, and Sonya. I don't think Chiaki did it. I think it was set up to make us think that the traitor did this, but it's not her. I don't think it's her style at all. The torture wounds interest me, because it could legitimately have been torture someone trying to get information. Or, if you think about it, it could have been just done because, let's face it, who here would know the most about torturing people? Well, probably Fury Hiko. It's kind of a nice way to point at him. Sonya is kind of the most immediate suspect because she was missing for a while, but then she has the whole information about the bombs being fake and all of that. But I kind of wonder about her. She was the person who was missing the longest. She had the most time to deal with it, to set things up. And I don't think... Actually, that's what I was about to address. No, we're gone. Player's not a suspect. Because we were always with ourselves, we know we're not a suspect. But other people may try to blame us. I am really, really curious about whether or not Nagito was actually able to set things up himself. But I'm not entirely sure how he would have done that. So I want to assume for the time being that he did not do it to himself. But I think we're going to have to see how some of the information pans out over the course of the trial, and then I will assess that just as we go. Is torture something everyone learns in grade school? Don't know. I basically don't think anyone and everyone. Right now, it's pretty much equal parts Shark Week, Sonya, and... I want to say no, it's not Fury Hiko. I want to say no. Shark Week, I don't fucking trust anymore. I mean, that dude has been on a downward spiral for a while, and this is well engineered. If we'd had truth bullets related to any of the videos, I would almost wonder if it was not even Nagato who set the distraction bomb up, you know, but... Is the MP3 player being pink significant? Hard to say, you worked the way you got here. What does Shark Week do? Shark Week has been just... He turned on us, he refuses to trust us. He's getting really, really bitchy. After Sonya and Gundam clearly had a thing going on, he just got angrier and angrier. So I really have issues with Shark Week at this point. So let's get this thing started.
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial. During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it.
That is a wow. Does Furuhiko stand alone? Is there okay? No, he's not totally alone.
If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person,
I'm assuming Ultimate Imposter is actually dead and they're not going to pull another dead person is not dead this time around, because if they did, I would seriously be upset with them for just rehashing their own writing that badly.
I'll punish everyone besides the Blackened, and that person will earn the right to leave this island!
Shark Week also had a lot of issues with Nagato. It's entirely possible he was torturing someone to try and find out who the traitor is, but I don't think Nagato actually knew.
Oh my! Monami? My cute
She's
little sister?
Up.
You're awfully quiet! What's happened to you?
Hey, Kanzael, how are you doing?
You've ascended the ladder of adulthood and reached the moon? Because you're a rabbit?
Still nothing.
One more time! Jeez! How about this one? This will be my final blow! It's useless.
Well, Monomi.
Please stop! I feel bad for Monomi.
You're right! Now's not the time for me to horse around with Monomi! The class trial has started, after all!
I'm doing well, Kanteo, thank you for asking. Some of the archive stuff is also over on my my YouTube, but not Danganronpa at this point. I need to get that moved over, but that's another question of time, which I have very little of lately.
The victim this time is Nagito, who is attempting to reveal the traitor for everyone's sake! Who in the world killed him? I'm so curious!
Oh, I don't feel that bad for her, Gryphots.
If he was killed for trying to reveal the traitor...
The assumption would be the traitor.
That traitor is obviously the killer. They were trying to shut Nagito up.
No, that might not be it.
Huh? Are you trying to protect the traitor? They didn't call out when we were in danger. Wait. Don't tell me you're the traitor!
And it begins.
Don't say something so stupid! There's no way in hell I'm the traitor!
Now that's more like it! Why don't you guys hurry and start arguing already?
The traitor, and the killer who murdered Nagito, is here, right? Are they the same person? Or... Alright, let's see what they got going on. Alright, let's see what they all have to say.
The killer didn't tape Nagito's mouth to shut him up! I'm telling you, they were torturing him!
The reason Nagito's body was covered with wounds...
It's because the killer tortured Nagito!
So that's why he was so beat up.
What were they trying to find out by torturing him?
definitely the bomb's hiding place.
No.
If so, the suspect is whoever found the bomb first.
That was Fuyuhiko. I found it by coincidence. There's no way I'd torture someone.
Interesting arguments. Okay. Are they really caused by torture? The point in torturing someone is to make them reveal information, right? And it's pointless if he can't talk.
The killer didn't tape Nagito's mouth to shut him up. I'm telling you, they were torturing him.
The reason Nagito's body was covered with wounds...
it's because the killer tortured Nagito.
No, that's wrong.
To be fair, you could have tortured him and then put it... the blood spatter isn't going to reach his face from his legs. And those are the real
torture
marks.
But Nagito's mouth was covered with duct tape, so he wouldn't have been able to confess anything. If he was being tortured for information, they wouldn't have taped his mouth like that.
Jury's out on whether Akane or Hiro is dumber. I feel like she's going to live through to the end just because Hiro did, you know? There's that level of nirvana stupidity where you're so dumb that you'll actually survive Danganronpa.
I'm prepared!
That didn't take long. Shark Week's on fire.
Ah, I just realized it! It's a trap!
Trap?
Stupid Hajime! You got caught in that trap!
Stupid? Alright, we're gonna have to see what he has to say.
Like you said, if Nagito's mouth was taped shut, you'd obviously assume he couldn't talk, right? But that was the trap! They wanted to hide the fact that he got interrogated!
What if you tape his mouth shut? How is he supposed to answer anything?
Pay attention! This is how it went. First, the killer tortured Nagito and got information about the bomb's location.
So what do we have
then, after they killed him, they duct-taped his mouth shut!
Okay, so the duct tape is actually the answer to that.
That was close, you guys. Thanks to me, you guys didn't get caught in the trap.
Sounds reasonable, but we know there's no blood under it, so that's our counter.
Pay attention! This is how it... First, the killer tortured Nagi and got information about the bomb's location.
You...
then, after they killed him...
allow me to cut through those words!
No, there's no doubt Nagito's mouth was covered with duct tape before he was beat up.
Hey, we know that 30% of the time, he's right all the time. Yeah, Shark Week is a little on fire.
What did you say?!
Who cares about the duct tape?
Hey, I love Thera, how you doing?
Might as well settle this with rock, paper, scissors.
We don't need to play a game. It's clear the duct tape was on his mouth before the torture even began.
Why do you always side with Hajime? Do you have a crush on him or something?
Are you in elementary school or something?
You were with us when I peeled the duct tape off Nagito's mouth, right? The blood on Nagito's face wasn't under the duct tape, remember?
The blood on his face came from his arm wounds.
I'm pretty sure that killing blow was basically dropped on him when we entered, like very Rube Goldberg fashion.
Which means the duct tape was on his face before his arms were even wounded.
And the duct tape had a lot of crinkles around his mouth.
What's interesting there is that means he had to be in a position where they could tie him up before they ever injured him at all.
He must have been struggling to open his mouth under the duct tape.
Perhaps the duct tape was used so we wouldn't be able to scream. Then it's like I said at the beginning. The tape wasn't for torture. It was to keep his mouth shut.
I wish they had shown us where the rest of the rope was. Because they show you the rope that's attached around his right wrist and that's burned off, but they don't show you where the rest of it ended up.
However, if they wanted to seal his mouth, they did not need to hurt him with such ferocity.
They probably had a deep grudge against Nagito.
then, are you saying the killer was trying to make him suffer?
If so, it's friggin' crazy. Did they go psycho or something?
No, they didn't just go crazy. Whoever did this must be one crafty bastard. If not, they wouldn't have taken the time to set fire to the crime scene and destroy all the evidence.
Hmm? The warehouse fire was for destroying evidence?
We can't think of any other reason.
I'm not so sure about that.
But who could have done that? When the fire occurred, everyone in this room was gathered in front of the warehouse.
Yeah, and right after I opened the warehouse door, the flames started burning from the very back.
Which means, it is plausible to think that nobody here set the fire.
Yeah.
Killer isn't one of us, but that's not the case, huh? I mean, it's wishful thinking.
Even if it was only a coincidence, the timing was just too perfect.
Based on the pattern up until now, we should suspect that some kind of setup was used for this.
Some kind of setup? Like what?
I do not know that, but that has been the pattern before.
That's our Miss Sonia. You have such an amazingly high intellect. Alrighty then. Let's think about this based on what Miss Sonia thinks. Is that okay, Miss Sonia?
And he's still looking for her approval.
Damn right it is!
Did she just copy Furuhiko? Reason for the fire, huh? You're right. We need to clear that up first. Well, we know it's based on the lighter. Specifically the type of lighter that remains on.
The direct cause of the fire was the oil lighter found at the crime scene, right?
The killer used some kind of setup. He lit the curtain on fire with the lighter.
Some kind of setup?
Did they use the oil as an improvised fuse?
Nope.
They probably just threw the lighter.
Nope.
Based on the shape of that oil lighter, it can stand upright while the flame is lit.
If they tipped over the lighter in some way, it could have ignited the curtain.
Some way?
Waiting for, what do we got?
Maybe they used invisible thread.
No.
There should have been a way to tip it over with sound waves.
Oh, shit. I saw the tip it over and was like, there it is. I'm like, sound waves? Oh, Christ. What am I doing?
Crap!
Ugh. Sorry. Didn't mean to agree
the
with Shark
cause of the fire. The oil lighter found at the
The killer used some kind. He lit the curtain on fire with some kind of setup.
Did they use the
Such
oil?
Like,
they probably just threw it based on the shape of that
oil.
The best thing is she basically just copied one of
Furuhiko's, it could have ignited the curtain.
Some way?
Furuhiko's lines.
Maybe they used invisible thread.
There should have been
a way to tip it over with sound wave.
Or perhaps opening the door caused.
Thank you. There we go.
I agree with
that. I
saw
tip it over and fired immediately. Bitch. I should know better than to agree with Shark Week on anything.
I also agree that opening the door is what started the fire.
Just as I thought, it was the wind pressure! A dust devil blown here from glorious Japan!
Close, Klonoa. It's close. Except, she's basically just hand on muscle. For the equivalent of flipping the bird, it's that.
No, not wind pressure. They probably used the Monokuma panels. A huge number of tipped-over Monokuma panels were found at the crime scene, right? It looked like they were scattered everywhere, but some were laying on top of each other in a single line. Just a single line leading from the warehouse door to the fire's origin.
Does that mean anything?
The killer probably arranged those Monokuma panels
Sonia,
to create a domino effect.
A domino effect? You mean those tiles kids play with by lining them up and tipping them over?
How common are dominoes in Japan, actually, come to think of it?
In place of those tiles, the killer used the Monokuma panels. So when we opened the warehouse door, the first panel toppled into the second.
Aw, see you later, Klonoa. Makes you wonder what kanji would be like in Danganronpa. See Mondo. That's nice to actually have, nice to have that particular view of things. So he was quite a distance away from the lighter.
And from there, they fell like dominoes until they reached the lighter at the end.
But wouldn't it be obvious that those big panels were falling over?
That's probably why they turned off the lights in the warehouse, so we wouldn't notice them.
So the reason the warehouse was dark was to hide the domino effect.
And one more thing. There was something else the killer did to hide the domino effect, right?
Yeah, he had big issues with biker gangs keeping his mom up. No question is, do they have blocks? Hey Celestial, how are you doing? Killer did one other thing to hide the domino effect and doesn't necessarily need to be visual, which would be, where's our audio here?
I see! You're talking about the MP3 player, right? That hymn blaring throughout the warehouse masked the sound of the falling panels.
Inside the warehouse felt even darker because our eyes were still used to the bright sunlight outside. Then that darkness, a loud hymnal blared throughout the warehouse at full volume. Hey, you guys hear something? Yeah, it's really damn loud. It's not you to like listening to this depressing crap. Now, I'm not talking about the music. As if on cue, it suddenly started. Hey, Silver,
that's
how you been?
It. So the strange sound was actually the sound of the panels falling.
But those sounds weren't the only strange thing, right?
She has really good ears. So does Monomi.
Looking back on it, it was also strange when we opened the door to the warehouse.
It's fine, I'll open it slowly. No, it's not the problem. Seriously, it'll be fine. Those words, Akane brushed off everyone's warning and slowly opened the door to the warehouse. It's not opening? Is there something blocking the door? I can barely open it. I know it's a trap. Seriously, just stop it, okay? I didn't tell you it'll be fine, I just gotta use a little more force. What happened to opening it slowly? Kana ignored their protest, and with a mighty kick, the door flew open.
Ah, so the door was being blocked by a Monokuma panel!
Imagine if she kicked it so hard she just scattered the panels and the whole thing didn't start.
And when we opened the door, the domino effect started, and the falling panels eventually reached the lighter.
Yeah, and that's how the warehouse caught on fire. At least, that's how it looks.
You don't look so sure.
At the time, Akane mentioned that she could barely open the door.
Because the panel was blocking it, right?
But the blocked doorway, there wasn't enough space for a person to fit through, right?
Is that a problem?
It's a major problem. I mean, that door was the only entrance to the warehouse.
That door was the only entrance to the warehouse. I see. Killer couldn't have left.
I see! If the panel was so close to the door that it could barely be opened, the killer inside the warehouse wouldn't be able to leave, right?
Well, to be fair, walking out and then putting the last panel in place when reaching through the gap in the door.
Now that you mention it,
but we don't have a really clear view of how close it was or how much the door could open.
Does that mean they were hiding inside?
No, we
Ooh,
were all there.
We were all outside the warehouse, you know.
Based on the patterns up until now, I believe some kind of setup was used.
You don't have to think so hard. There's actually only one person who could have possibly done this.
Are we seriously gonna point at Nagito? Huh.
You don't mean...
Did he really do it to himself? God, that'll be a thing to work through. What if that's true? This murder...
Hajime? What do you mean?
The person who set up the domino effect inside the warehouse. There's only one person who could have done that. That would be Nagitroll.
This is my answer! What if it was Nagito?
Why'd you bring him up? He's the victim, you know.
That was not interesting. I'm not sure how he would have accomplished the tying, but the pattern of blood on his hands, it would match if he stabbed himself. Because we know he was holding something.
He wasn't just the victim. Maybe.
Huh?
Not just the victim? What does that mean?
He was the victim. And he was the perpetrator, too. Maybe.
I don't think he could have used the poison as a painkiller because it said that it acts incredibly fast. He would have been dead before he could do anything. But he could have killed himself before the spear. Well, no, the spear is listed as the cause of death. But who's to say he didn't just straight up respeed himself entirely, poison and all. I mean, we are missing a chunk of the poison bottle.
Are you saying this was a suicide? Don't be stupid! His body was covered in torture wounds. Or did you already forget?
Yeah, do we really think he's not crazy enough to do that himself?
Are you saying those were all self-inflicted?
Jackie's my favorite character for Airbus just because she's competent.
But Nagito might do something like that, don't you think?
That's not the issue! He was tied up, remember? Even for a creep like Nagito, it'd be impossible for him to tie up his own arms and legs.
Well, the one part's burned through already. The assumption could have been that the fire did it, but he still had a free hand.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, as long as you understand.
Questioning yourself is a symptom of being confident. I suspect there was a lot of tabun in her Japanese.
It seems we need to discuss how Nagito was able to tie himself up.
Need to discuss? That's not necessary at all. No matter how much you think about it, it's clearly impossible.
Yeah, me too, Dalai Lama. I have a lot of enjoyment in competent characters, and it's why I have so little tolerance for people who are not competent. Hey, Seta. Yeah, we're on this chapter already. We also didn't even stream the last 2 days. We got here on Saturday. Generally speaking, I either get through an entire chapter in investigation or an entire trial, so generally 2 days per chapter. I feel like I'm overlooking something. Alright, this is probably gonna be the burned rope.
To actually tie up your own arms and legs. That's obviously impossible!
Tying just the legs is one thing, but tying both arms would be impossible.
We're assuming he was tied up.
You couldn't do much with the free arm.
It'd be impossible if you were by yourself.
How about if you use your teeth? Or if you use your front tail?
Dirty joke! Is that a dirty joke?
I'm sorry, did she just imply that Nagito has a prehensile penis? So that would be a hell of a trick, I'm not gonna lie, but I'm gonna assume that's not the answer.
To actually tie up your own arms and legs.
I don't think you did.
No, that's wrong!
Hold on a sec. Isn't that premise flawed?
What? I mean, it's no mistake that his arms and legs were...
No, it shouldn't have been both of his arms. The rope on his right arm was completely burnt up. Based on that, you can't say he was tied up.
Yeah, and there's a knife in his hand, it doesn't mean his hand's pinned to the floor.
That was just burned by the fire. He should have been tied up before then.
It burned because of the fire. Like you said, it might look like that. But that was part of the trap. There's concrete evidence that proves it.
In fact, those jackets unaffected.
I see! Take a close look at his right sleeve. Even though the rope was burnt up, his sleeve wasn't burned at all. Wouldn't you agree?
Of course, if he offed himself in this fantastic manner, then potentially there's going to be six survivors again. I was kind of hoping for less people to survive than Danganronpa 1.
A burn like this, we'll no see. Matter how you think about
Still
it, is unnatural. That rope was burned in advance so it would look like it was burned in the fire.
Then Nagito's right arm wasn't tied up, right? He was able to move it freely, right?
I'm the only one who finds Hajime's voice really pleasant to listen to. Well, you should be able to watch pretty much any damn dub these days then. Johnny Young botches in so many things.
Yeah, that should be the case.
Hajime, that's awesome! I'll let you cop a feel if you want.
Well, that right there is why we probably like her more than Hiro.
Akane! You should not give it away for free! Make sure they pay you first!
Hard to argue that.
That's definitely wrong.
It says the... Oh my god.
Fine. I just gotta get a Benjamin from him before I let him touch me, right?
I'm not paying $100 to cop a feel.
That's not what I meant. I'm talking about Nagito. I mean, even if his right hand wasn't tied up, the knife was still stabbed into it, you know?
These people. These are our survivors, ladies and gentlemen. These are our survivors.
It's impossible to stab a knife into your right hand with your right hand.
Ah, that much is obvious.
Of course, if you hold it in the other hand and then slam your hand down on it.
Hajime, you tricked me. Give me back that Benjamin.
You didn't pay me. Not only did she try to charge me, she wants the money back? What the heck?
Hold on. There should be a way.
Then hurry up and spill it.
If it's something lame,
no,
I'll make
Sonny
you get back
Sonia.
To Benjamin with 10,000% interest.
All right, I will give you back exactly what you gave me. Oh god, what was the tactical pimping? Is that quote 20? Oh, I don't remember. We have a tactical pimping quote somewhere in there. Way to stab yourself in your right hand using only your right hand. Okay, there's definitely an answer for this. Interesting.
Even if Nagito's right hand was free, how could he stab his right hand with his right hand?
If he threw the knife into the air and let the knife fall, could he stab his hand that way?
Is he a throwing knife expert?
Could he anchor it?
Maybe he propped the knife somehow?
Yep,
I agree with that!
Plushie. There it is! Tactical Pimping 101, managing time with your bitches. Thank you, Persona 3.
The life-size Monokuma plushie! He must have used that to prop the knife!
Makes sense. That's why there was a big hole in the plushie's stomach. He inserted the knife handle into that hole to prop it up. Then he slammed his hand onto it.
Thank you for the follow. Welcome to Radio Zero.
If that's it, he had to place the plushie near him. And it also explains the mysterious blood on the plushie.
So the blood on the plushie came from Nagito after he stabbed the knife into his own right hand.
I see. So that's the trick.
But for a moment, I seriously thought Monokuma died or something.
Let's figure out exactly how our friend elaborately killed himself. The game! Yeah, that sounds about right. I dig it.
A bleeding plushie is super scary! It's got the same fear factor as a doll whose hair grows too long!
What happened to the Estus flask? There's not a lot of Estus left.
After stabbing his hand, he no longer needed the plushie, so he cast it off toward the fire's origin point.
He probably thought the fire would incinerate it and destroy the evidence.
I gotta say, Nagito, you are kinda magnificent.
So what do you think now, Fuyuhiko?
I get what you're saying about the wound on his right hand, but there's still one huge problem. The spear. Basically, you're saying Nagito committed suicide by impaling himself with a spear, right?
Well, I'm guessing he was holding on to the, he probably looped it up over the ceiling, held the one end, let go, let it drop.
If you think about the order, getting killed by the spear should have been the last thing to happen to Nagito. If that's true, how is that possible? He can't grab a spear with his right hand if a knife is stabbed into it and his left hand was all tied up.
Then he probably took the spear first, and as he endured the pain, he stabbed the knife into his right hand.
There is a limit to his constitution. If you got penetrated by something so big and thick, you would die instantly.
Phrasing, son. Phrasing.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch all that.
Thanks, Shark Week.
Like I said, if you got penetrated by something so big and thick, you would die instantly.
Say it one more time. I need to record it. For reasons.
Hey, bastard, you better cut it out!
Yeah. Can we just see, let's get some CLZ loot in chat there. I think it's earned it. Hey, Hard Lexicon, how you doing? What have you walked in on? Somebody with a poor grasp of the English language making themselves look bad.
Like she said, in that condition, it's very difficult to stab yourself with a spear. It'd be hard to use a spear with a knife stab into your right hand while your left hand is tied up.
So you're saying it's impossible?
Bad Shark Week, bad.
But no matter what I think, I can't believe Nagito's death was caused by someone else.
It has been a while, Heart. How have you been?
I also agree with that.
Oh, it shows up for me, Amy. You might just have to refresh.
To think that one of us could kill someone with such cruelty, I could never believe that.
You say you can't believe it? You just don't want to believe it, right?
I haven't been too bad, Heart. Been ticking along. Mostly just doing stuff to try and keep the stream going ahead of everything else.
But that's why you keep getting betrayed over and over again, right?
Where'd you travel
off
to?
Same goes for this time, too.
You just shut your mouth. It's against the rules to interfere with everyone. If you even think about doing anything, I have a plan of my own.
Oh, weird. CLZ loot shows up for me just fine.
Mamonomy's sassing me!
But it's just as Monokuma said. We've been betrayed over and over again so far, so this might also be the same. Calling this a suicide takes too much for granted, and it's too convenient.
Then are you saying there is a killer among us, Kazuichi?
Oh, good God, Heart, the timing on that.
Of course that doesn't include Miss Sonia and me.
As Kazuichi said, it's true we've been constantly betrayed.
So does anyone other than me correctly see that emote?
But even if I'm betrayed again, I still want to believe in everyone. No matter how many times I may be betrayed, I still want to believe in everyone.
I also want to believe that there's no killer, but suicide is unimaginable.
Do you really think so?
But you said it too. It'd be impossible for him to stab himself with a spear in his condition.
Oh man, that's weird. I wonder why so there is a split on people who can and can't see it.
I did say difficult. But I never said impossible.
For anyone who doesn't see it, I assume you're using BTTV? Okay, no, B-Sent has BTTV and doesn't see it. I don't know what's going on then. Though granted, it's not going to show up in I don't think it'll... Actually, I have no idea if it will. I don't think it'll show up in the stuff on screen. Huh?
I feel that there's some way he could have stabbed himself with that spear.
What kind of way?
I don't know.
You don't know?
It's impossible to figure out by myself. So let's think about it together.
He made a very, very calculated throw, launched the spear straight up, and waited under it while he did all the other horrible things to himself. No, not really.
That's how. We made it this far up till now.
I bet Nagito could do that.
Everyone, working together.
She's right. I made it through several ordeals up till now by doing that. And even now.
All right, let's do this.